हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल कवर अनदर टॉपिक दिस ईयर अंगारिका संकष्टी चतुर्थी फॉल्स ऑन 2 मार्च 2021। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग एंड सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ अंगारिका चतुर्थी, द स्टोरी बिहाइंड अंगारिका चतुर्थी and why Ganesha is considered as the lord of wisdom and remover of obstacles. Now we know that the fourth day after the full moon day, that is Purnima, is known as Chaturthi. Okay, so we have a Chaturthi every month, but this time the Chaturthi comes in the Krishna Paksha, that is in the dark phase of the moon or the waning moon, okay, and it falls on a Tuesday, and therefore it is also called as Angarika Chaturthi. This Chaturthi, which falls on Tuesday, is very special, and in this video I will tell you the story behind why this Angarika Sankashti Chaturthi is celebrated. Another thing to note is that this Chaturthi falls in the month of Magh, and this is also known as Magh Angarika Sankashti Chaturthi. Magh is a very holy month for the Hindus and is very dear to Lord Ganesha. So let us try to understand the story behind this Chaturthi. Om Shri Siddhi Vinayakaya Namaha. So long time ago, there lived a Rishi or a sage called as Bharadwaj. Bharadwaj was a very learned sage. Bharadwaj and goddess Earth had a son called as Arun. Arun means one who is red in complexion. Okay. Mother Earth took care of Arun for 7 long years. After that, Bharadwaj Rishi made him study various scriptures, rituals, Vedas and other texts. He gave him a Ganesh mantra and told him to go and practice that mantra. Arun did as Rishi Bharadwaj told him, and he started chanting that mantra every day. In a way, he now started developing great love and devotion for Lord Ganesha. He went to the banks of the river Ganga and did many rituals to please Lord Ganesha. He did intense fasting, he did intense meditation, and he did intense chanting of the mantras of Lord Ganesha. Finally, on the Tuesday and Chaturthi of the Magh month, Lord Ganesha appeared before him. He told Arun that I am intensely pleased with your devotion towards me, so ask for a boon. Arun said, I don't want anything except one thing, that my name should always be associated with your name. Lord Ganesha agreed to this, and he blessed Arun with prosperity and moksha. He also told Arun that from now on, your name will be known as Angarak, and whoever does fasting and chanting of mantras on this day, that is one who chants Ganesh mantras on this day and also does fasting, all obstacles in his path will be removed and he will attain the highest state. Now Lord Ganesha had appeared before Arun on a Chaturthi in the Magh month on the day of Tuesday in Krishna Paksha. Now this time the Angarika Sankashti falls on 2 March 2021. It is also falling on a Tuesday. It is a Chaturthi. It falls in the Krishna Paksha, and this month is Magh. And therefore this Angarika Sankashti has a very special significance, as the boon of Ganesha particularly gets activated on this day. So if on this Tuesday, that is 2nd March 2021, you chant and pray to Lord Ganesha and chant his mantras and do fasting for the whole day, Ganesha has promised that all obstacles in your path will be removed and you will get ultimate success. So this is the significance of Angarika Chaturthi, which falls on 2nd March 2021. The day of Tuesday was also named after Arun. We know that Tuesday is known as Mangalwar, and one name for Mangal is also Angarak. Angarak means something which is red hot. Okay, and therefore this Chaturthi is known as Angarika Chaturthi. It is also known as Angarika Sankashti Chaturthi or Angarika Sankat Har Chaturthi, which means all the obstacles are removed. Sankat means difficulty or obstacles that come in your path. Okay, and Sankat Hara means to remove those difficulties. Therefore, this Chaturthi is known as Angarika Sankashti Chaturthi or Angarika Sankat Har Chaturthi. Now let us understand the story of how Ganesha became the god of wisdom and a remover of obstacles. So long time ago, there was a sage called Durvasa, and he was going from Vaikuntha, the abode of Vishnu, to Kailasha, the abode of Lord Shiva. On the way, he met Lord Indra. Indra was busy looking at the dance of an apsara called Rambha. However, Indra noticed Durvasa and he bowed before him and asked him for his blessings. Durvasa was pleased with Indra and he gave him a flower, that is a Parijata flower, which Lord Vishnu had given to Durvasa. Durvasa told Indra that this flower is a special flower. If you keep this flower on your head, you will get the same knowledge level as Lord Vishnu. That is, anyone who keeps this flower on his head gets knowledge equivalent to that of Lord Vishnu, and he will also be as valorous as Lord Vishnu. Durvasa gave the flower to Indra and he went on his way. However, Indra was busy occupied looking at the dance of Rambha, and so he kept that flower on the head of his elephant. Now what happened is, this flower was a special flower, and since it was kept on the head of the elephant now got all the knowledge in the world and became equivalent to Lord Vishnu in knowledge. The elephant also became valorous. It defeated all other elephants and left Indra and went away to a forest. Had Indra kept the flower on his head, Indra would have become as knowledgeable as Lord Vishnu. But when one is occupied in worldly matters, in lustful matters, it is very difficult to gain real knowledge. Many months passed by post this incident, and a child was born to Shiva and Parvati, and this child was known as Ganesha. Now when Ganesha was born, we all know that Ganesha prevented Shiva from entering into Kailasha, and in return Shiva along with the Devas fought a battle with this child and cut off his head. When Ganesha's head was destroyed, Parvati was very angry and she took the form of Mahakali. And she said, "I will destroy the entire world if my son, who is unjustly killed, is not brought back to life." Shiva and the other gods agreed to this condition. But Parvati was still not satisfied. She said that, "I want one more boon, that my child will be the first to be worshipped among gods. He will also have the power to remove all obstacles." Lord Shiva and the other gods agreed to this, and therefore Ganesha is first worshipped among all the deities. He is also known as Pratham Pujaniya, means one who is offered worship first. And Ganesha has the special power to remove all obstacles that come in anyone's path. Therefore, he is also known as Vignaharta, or the remover of obstacles. Now, the severed head of the boy had to be replaced by some other head. So, Lord Vishnu was told to go in the northern direction and get the head of the first animal that he sees. When Lord Vishnu went in the northern direction, the first animal that he saw was the same elephant on whose head Indra had placed that special Parijat flower. And therefore, this elephant was as wise as Lord Vishnu himself. Lord Vishnu took his Sudarshan Chakra and cut off the head of the elephant with his due permission. This head was then used to replace the head of the boy, and therefore Ganesha has an elephant head, and therefore Ganesha has immense wisdom equivalent to that of Lord Vishnu, and therefore Ganesha is also known as the god of wisdom. He has two consorts, Riddhi and Siddhi. Riddhi means growth, and Siddhi means the power to attain something. Therefore, Ganesha gives you both growth as well as the power to attain what you desire, and this can happen only once all the obstacles in your path are removed. And therefore, Ganesha is also known as the dispeller of obstacles, the god of wisdom. So, on Angarika Chaturthi, what should you do? One thing you can do is you can fast the entire day. Okay. If you cannot do a complete fasting, just try eating fruits, drinking some milk and water on this day. The next thing you can do is you can chant the mantras of Ganesha. So, you can chant the mantra Om Gang Ganpataye Namaha. Okay. You can chant 108 times, that makes one mala. You can chant up to 10 malas or more on this day. You can offer prasad such as modak to Lord Ganesha. Okay. You can also offer arga or water to Lord Ganesha in a copper vessel on this day. And you can break your fast once you see the rising moon in the sky at around 9:27. If you do not see the moon in the sky, you can still break your fast by offering your prayers to Lord Ganesha along with some prasad, and then you can distribute this prasad among your family members. Doing complete fasting and chanting on this day will remove all obstacles in your path and give you ultimate success in your life. So friends, this is the story behind the meaning and significance of Angarika Sankathar Chaturthi or Angarika Sankashti Chaturthi. And we have also seen why Ganesha is known as the god of wisdom and the remover of obstacles. So friends, if you like this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. To know more about us, you can visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. For any queries, for any consultation, please email us at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com and we'll be glad to assist you. So friends, thanks a lot. We'll see you soon shortly with another video. Till then, bye, take care, stay safe.